Welcome to Bright Hope Creations. I'm Kara, and today we're peeking into this pumpkin to see what or who is inside. We're using the Lawn Fawn pumpkin house and the chimney from the mushroom house, stitch dens, you autumn know, let's go nuts, the fireplace from Christmas Dreams, and a leaf from Into the Woods. I cut the pumpkin out of white, fake tan, and sticky note cardstock and used the smallest stitch den die on the yellow one. I scored the sides of the pumpkin on one side, and I think this is about a quarter inch. It's gonna create a hinge on the top two layers, which the orange one will be on the top and then the yellow in the center. That way the pumpkin will open up like a little book. I'm starting with that center piece. I want to recreate the guts of the pumpkin. So if you sliced a pumpkin open, you would see the hard shell and the flesh and then all the little stringy pieces. But first I want to stamp in some pumpkin seeds, and I'm using that leaf from Into the Woods. Into the Woods. I don't know. That always makes me think of that musical. But anyway, so I'm stamping out those pumpkin seeds and I'm putting in the string pieces after that. I'm coloring the pumpkin seeds first so that I see them and know where to put the little strings. And so I'm using E50, E70, and E51 on those pumpkin seeds. Now to add the strings. And I googled the inside of a pumpkin. So there's pulp, which is that flesh around, and then the fibrous strands, which is the guts or the slimy parts inside that you take out when you're carving a face or using it as a squirrel house. To create some depth, I'm using darker colors right up by the flesh part and then lightening up as I go towards the center. And I'm using a variety of YR20s and YR-teens. And the YR20s are kind of a browner orange, and the teens are a brighter orange. Now that I have all my strings, I want to blend everything together. So I'm using that YR21, a light color, to kind of make it all kind of smoothen out together. So this would be kind of my first layer. Next, I'll go around the outside with the YR14, and that's going to give me my orange shell. Now, when I go back through and do another layer of those strings, it's going to bring a lot more depth to this inside of the pumpkin. I'll smooth that out a little bit, and then I can start putting on the depth of the ribs of the pumpkin. See, I told you I googled it. So I'm well versed in the anatomy of a pumpkin. So I'm using those same YR20s and the teens, and I'm starting in those areas that are stitched so that it shows me a nice rib section. And then go in there with the darkest colors and then blend out on both sides, and that will make it look like it is rounded. I keep going out lighter and lighter, and eventually I use a YR00 to make it smooth so it's part of that cardstock color. Create a little texture by going up and down in a curved way to make it follow those lines that are already there on the die cut. Darken up those lines a little bit, and then also you can see I am adding some more shading to the bottom of the pumpkin since that will be on the ground, so less hit by the sunlight. The windows and door are cut out of canned pumpkin cardstock, and the stem and some leaves are sage cardstock, and other leaves and tendrils are both textured dot gemstone, which is the teal color out of that pack, and then also rainforest cardstock. I wanted my stem to look like it was green going to brown, so I'm using the E30s on that stem. But I also go back with some blue-green teens like I am using on these leaves. And then coloring up those windows just makes it look like there's a little bit of a glow using Y32 and 35. And then I can glue on the window frames onto that glow behind them. That same die cut works for the glow behind the door, if you're not going to open the door, which I'm not going to open the door in this one since our whole pumpkin is opening up. Put on a little door handle and then these cute little terracotta pots, and those I cut out of canned pumpkin as well and shaded. And then this house needs a chimney. This chimney is from the mushroom house because there is a fireplace inside, and I know that would concern people if there was no way for that smoke to come out. Adding a little glow to the lanterns, and then it's time to work on the inside. So I'm stamping using jellyfish ink, and that's great for no-line coloring. I stamp my little squirrel who is sleeping, and I'm masking him with a little bit of sticky post-it paper, and then I can stamp my leaves behind him, and he's all nestled in those leaves. Now for the inside, the very back of the pumpkin, I'm stashing his acorns in there, and I want to put in a lot of acorns, so I'm using those masks to have some acorns behind others. Always front first. Whatever you want in the front, you stamp first and then mask it, and then whatever goes behind that will be behind the mask. So that's how I remember. I always remember front first. I'm adding now some leaves, and you can see the fireplace in there too. And these leaves are tucked under the acorns or behind them. And it's all set now to color. I started by just finding those acorns and adding some color. I'll do some shading later, but I wanted to make sure that I knew where they all were before I colored over them, giving them some defining lines so I can tell them apart. And then I've started on the fireplace. The bricks are blocked out in R22, and I'm shading in R24 and also R35, but I'm using cool grays and a little warm gray, deepen up the shading and add some mortar between the bricks. Then we'll light the fire with YR21 and 14. Back of the fireplace is C6. Shaded to a C4, and then I'm putting a glow around the fire with a Y32, and then coming back in there with a C1 to make it look like it's the back of the fireplace. I'll fill in the pumpkin floors and keep some glow from the fireplace, and fill in the walls. I'm moving fast through the coloring today. There's a lot of coloring in this little scene, so I don't want to take all the time showing every detail. When I first edited this video, I think it was about 45 minutes edited. So I really had to cut down how much time I was using to show the coloring. Now I'm back to coloring those acorns. So I'm putting in the detail shading, and I'm using an E81 and 84, those two. They're a bit of a greener brown, and I'm also using the C6 to get into those deep crevices. Well, I already started coloring in the leaves around our squirrel here. Again, just saving some time for your viewing pleasure. But now with our squirrel, I'm starting with E11, defining lines and putting in some of the shading. And then I'll use an E13, darken up those shadows, and then come in with that E11 to blend them out. Now this is one giant pumpkin because that squirrel looks like he's pretty small in there. He's got a nice room to move, and he's in some pretty big leaves as well. But he's a happy guy. He's got all those acorns stored, and he's hunkered down for a long winter. I keep going section by section, and I'm using E-teens, but I will eventually redden him up. He's going to be a red squirrel with the R02 and 05, and then he almost looks like a fox. So this tail, I left the tip of it white and actually come back after the video and color that in a little bit, because I was looking at red squirrels online, and no, they don't have white tipped tails, at least not in my area. So he's not a fox. He is a squirrel. I mean, what kind of fox would sleep in a pumpkin anyway? I know, squirrels don't sleep in pumpkins. I do know. All right, well, I also used an E07 to get some nice dark shading in around his tail and in those little deep crevices where he's curled up. Blend that back out a bit with the R05. Blend that even further now with an R02. And he's pretty much set, except that white tail. That will get colored later. I'm using a Prismacolor pencil to add in his nose and his eyes. This is a sepia color. Cutting him out with that leaf coordinating die, the leaf pile. You might have noticed that I also darkened those leaves around him. Give him a real rich color. Now he's going to nestle into the center panel so that you can see everything going on behind him. And I also want to put in the sentiment now. Because he's hibernating, he missed a birthday like I did. And so I needed a belated birthday card. And so that's where the inspiration came for this one. It says, "Aw nuts." And I'm figuring out where to stamp that on the back. I'm stamping that with Lawn Fawn's walnut ink. And this sentiment comes from the Let's Go Nuts stamp set. So the second part says, "I forgot your birthday." And that will be hidden by the squirrel until the page is turned. And I'm adding a few more fibrous strands to the back of the pumpkin. Little detail there. And would you look at that? It's time to assemble. So I'm using 1/8-inch double-sided tape, something very strong, to hold that cardstock together on the hinge. So I'm going to make sure that it's placed right over the one underneath so that my pumpkins all match up. Put some tape on the front panel as well. I make sure that those three pieces are all lined up nice. And then it's time to construct this house. So I'm using a tape runner adhesive to add the door and the windows and the stem. Now anything that is going on this house on the front needs to be attached to the front but can't overlap on the side, on the one side, so that things don't interfere when it's opening. Now here's that chimney, that very necessary chimney, and I can put that on the very back of the house so that when this front flap opens, the chimney will still remain there. All right, well, we're creating a pumpkin patch for this pumpkin house, and so I'm using some distress oxides and a blender brush, and I'm kind of going with kind of a Monet style back. So it kind of gives the feel of pumpkin patch behind it, leaves and greenery and sky, but nothing's really defined. I'm using bundled sage and evergreen bough, and I've used several for the sky, trying to find the right colors to blend for autumn sky. And I have faded jeans and broken china, but it really kind of came together once I used speckled egg. That's the color that kind of made this moody blue background. I'm blending the dirt with walnut stain and vintage photo on some craft cardstock. And I'll smush a little of the distress oxides onto a piece of plastic. Actually, it's the back of my stamp package, but I'm going to add a little bit of water and flick it onto my background. So here's the dirt part. I'm covering everything else up so that they don't get dirty. I'm using a stiff brush and my finger, so my finger's going to be pretty inky. And I'm using evergreen bough for the leafy areas. Now I can attach the ground to the back panel. And I have my pumpkin center there so I can decide where I want that path to go. Adhere the pumpkin onto the back panel and it opens just fine. And then I can attach leaves all over, wherever I want them. I want this to look like pumpkin patch. So I'm going to add a bunch of leaves down at the bottom. And I just want to make sure that I don't overlap that pumpkin house. So I'm tucking everything behind the back panel of the house, adding some vines down below. I have some vines in the pots in the front of the house. And I'm putting the tendrils up at the top. Now I'm going to steal a leaf from one side because I want to hide the tendril that's coming to the right side because I want it to be hanging the lantern. So I decided where the lantern needed to be and then the tendril followed. But I wanted the stem off of this leaf because otherwise I wouldn't know where this leaf was coming from. So I took that leaf stem off. Now to add a bit of color, this die set comes with little flowers and the centers of the flowers. So I cut out those centers, but left them in the paper that I die cut them out of. And I'm taking some glue on the back of my flower and adding the flower to the center and then popping that center out. And then now I have the flower with the center behind it. I'll do a little flower arranging and then I can glue them down, just picking them up to move them slightly, putting some glue down and putting them back where I want them. I'll adhere the panel to a 4.25 by 5.5 inch note card, and this card is all done. Let's take a look. Here's our squirrel sleeping in the center and the warm fire behind him and all his acorns. And this was fun to no line color, but you could certainly stamp it out in black or other colored inks as well and color that in. Well, I hope you enjoyed this journey into the center of a pumpkin to see what's inside. I hope it inspires you to carve out a paper pumpkin for yourself. Thanks for watching and have a great day. Bye!